So, Prime Minister, I mean, this is the famous Netanyahu map that everyone talks about in your office. And yeah. I guess what is fascinating to me is when you look at this in scale, yeah. is how small Israel seems by comparison to the Middle East.
How small it is. I mean, the Middle East starts here, sort of there on the edge of the wall. That's Morocco. This is Tunisia. This is Libya, which is about 100 times the size of Israel. Egypt, about 40 times the size of Israel. This is the Sinai Desert. Saudi Arabia, God knows how many times. Iraq, Syria, Iran. You want to see Israel now? Here's Israel. My finger covers it with the West Bank. Everything. So it's a tiny country. Tiny, surrounded, shall we say, living in a very tough neighborhood. Now, you know, if you're small, it's not necessarily a problem. I mean, Luxembourg doesn't have a security problem.
Can I ask you a stupid question?
But if Luxembourg were surrounded by the kind of neighborhood that we're surrounded by, well,
can I ask
that's
a,
another matter.
Can I ask what may sound a stupid question? Yeah. Do you ever wish Israel wasn't there? Or wish it had just been stuck near Luxembourg? Would that make life a lot easier for everybody?
Well, you know, it might make our life easier, but it wouldn't materially make the difference. You could stick Belgium in here, and the same thing would happen, because the people who want us out, they don't want any Western presence here. And guess what? Increasingly, they don't want any Western presence here either. They have dreams of reestablishing the caliphate.
Finally, Prime Minister, this, I believe, is you and your brother, who tragically died in Entebbe. Right. What do you think when you see that picture?
Well, first, that I have to go on a diet. Secondly, that how young we were. But I remember the day that was shot. That's on the Dead Sea, actually. And we had a great time. He was taking a leave out of the army. This is his picture a few weeks before he fell in Entebbe. I think of him a lot, and I often ask myself, what would he be doing?
Do you think that pulling off a peace deal might be the greatest legacy you could give your brother?
If it holds, yes. A peace that holds, yes.
Prime Minister, thank you very much.
Thank you.
It's been a pleasure to meet you.